Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be continuing in the series of What If Saitama Was in My Hero Academia. This is part 7, so if you haven't seen the previous part, go check that out. That one will be in the description below. But yeah, without further ado, let's begin part 7. After the events of the training camp, everyone is a little shook up. When everyone is at the hospital, and Kirishima and Shoto say they're going after Bakugo, Saitama is stopped by two police officers. They tell Saitama to go to the police station where he will be met by Naomasa and the chief of police. At arrival, Saitama is instantly greeted by multiple big-name heroes such as Eddshot and Gang Orca. The two look at him, giving him a menacing look. Saitama is then brought to a secure room where the chief of police and Naomasa explain what is happening. After the two share their plan, Saitama asks why he is here. The chief goes on to tell Saitama about three heroes from UA that stopped the hero killer. The chief goes on to tell Saitama that they want to start using students in real life scenarios, and since Saitama is the strongest by far, they would like his help in crowd control and other minor details that might be affected during their mission. The chief goes on to tell Saitama that he will be given a certificate that allows him to use his quirk only in a necessary situation. He of course agrees, and his uniform is handed to him. During this time, Deku and the other four students track out and arrive at the city in which Bakugo is located. At arrival, they see a broadcast of Mr. Aizawa being grilled by reporters. Before the heroes track off on their assignments, everybody asks why a student is here. All Might stands up for Saitama, telling everyone that he is much stronger than he looks, and of course, when everyone turns to him, Saitama is not paying attention. When Deku's team gets to the warehouse, they find out about the Nomus. During this time, All Might smashes in, and all of the villains are apprehended. At the same time, the other half of the heroes stop the Nomu. Saitama pushes the back civilians as they try to approach the smashed building, but is not really paying attention as there is a market with amazing deals. However, suddenly the streets are filled with Nomu and Bakugo is taken away. It becomes abundantly clear that All For One was behind this, and the team sent to stop the Nomu is taken out. All Might tells Endeavor that he's heading on and for Saitama to help smash the Nomu. Saitama, still not paying attention, gets hit by one of Endeavor's flames as he tells him not to chicken out now. Saitama, seeing the problem, gets a punch ready and from about 20 feet throws it, sending all the Nomu flying and destroying most of the road. Endeavor goes into shock as he watches Saitama start walking towards All Might's location. Just as All Might is out of steam and in his skinny form, Saitama walks over to him and asks himself why the janitor from the USJ is here. He goes over to ask if he's alright, and All Might tells him to run. All For One then goes on a monologue about how he failed to be a symbol of hope, and how he'll ruin the world starting with his student. Saitama becomes angry with this, and just as All For One is about to blast the two, Saitama gets a serious punch ready and hits All For One, sending him into every building imaginable and shaking the city. The crowd roars as Saitama picks up All Might and walks him to Gran Torino. All Might then asks Saitama why he wants to be a hero. Saitama simply responds with, "It's fun." The three laugh and the rescue for Bakugo was a success. The next day or so, Class 1A is brought to their new residence. At arrival, everyone praises Saitama, which puts a warm feeling in him that he hasn't felt in a while. After being lectured about trust by Mr. Aizawa, the class has a contest to see whose room is best. When it comes to Saitama's room, it's pretty boring, like Uraraka's and Ojiro's room. The day ends and the Class 1A gets ready for their training to begin for the hero licensing exam. Some time had passed since the incident with the League of Villains, and Class 1A was about to take their provisional hero licensing exam. However, before the class takes them, Class 1A will be creating or working on their special moves. At the TDL, while everyone has an idea of their special moves, Deku and Saitama have a tough time thinking of something. Ectoplasm then brings up the fact that he could use one of All Might's signature moves, but Saitama shuts him down, saying it would be too flashy. Instead, Saitama asks if he can use his serious punch as a special move. Ectoplasm chuckles as he gives Saitama the green light. Saitama winds up and throws his serious punch at Ectoplasm. Ectoplasm and everyone inside the TDL is blown outward as the building collapses into rubble. Everyone, especially Cementos, is distraught at their new facility's predicament. Saitama comes out of the rubble and simply says sorry. The next day, where the class is now training outside, Cementos building structures like in the TDL. After a while, Bakugo uses his new AP shot, and a piece of rubble comes falling towards a brittle All Might. Like in canon, Deku wrecks it, giving Deku his new abilities. Before the class knows it, it's the date of the Provisional Hero Licensing Exam. At the location, the class is introduced to Yorashi. When all the kids line up in the hall, there's a different vibe. Instead of everyone paying attention to the commissioner, everyone is staring at Saitama, whom is oblivious to this. Before the students know it, the competition begins, and while Deku tries to get everyone together, Bakugo, Kaminari, and Kirishima go off, and Saitama and Shoto go off on their separate paths as well. When the horn rings, Saitama's serious face turns on, and he motors, hitting 9 people with balls in a matter of 10 seconds. The commissioner freaks out on this, and everyone in the arena is completely blown away. Even Mr. Aizawa in the stands is impressed on how quick it took him. In the waiting room, Saitama awaits his comrades as he munches on free food provided by the staff. After everyone arrives and talks amongst one another about the hardships they went through, the second round starts. Once again, Saitama goes off on his own, looking for stragglers. After some time of doing absolutely nothing, Gang Orker and his crew are introduced to the scenario. Shoto and Yoroshi have their battle with him, and coincidentally, Saitama walks on in. Gang Orca tells Saitama that his run-in with the League of Villains was a fluke, and Gang Orca crashes Saitama with all his power, punching him straight in the face. Saitama gets pushed back about a meter. Saitama then claps back, sending him flying into the stands. Suddenly, the test ends, and Kaminari and Kirishima bring the last two people to safety. Everyone is then sent back to the changing rooms to await their results. On the stadium floor, students look for their scores vigorously. Saitama looks in the S section and sees his name. Sadly, Shoto and Bakugo still fail. When everyone gets their papers, Saitama got an 81 out of 100 and a note telling him to meet with the commissioner afterwards. When Saitama walks up to them, he is told that he was always going to pass due to his appearance in the League of Villains attack. However, they were very disappointed due to his lack of motivation. Saitama leaves, reminiscing over the words of the commissioner and contemplating why he trained so immensely for the power that he has. The day would end with Bakugo and Deku fighting. However, I think this time Deku is going to be a bit more confident and their fight would go to a draw. Some time would pass, and after Deku's sentence was up, Class 1A was introduced to the work studies and the Big Three. And that's going to do it for this episode of What If Saitama Was in My Hero Academia. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, hit the like button, do all that stuff that YouTubers ask for. And I'll see you next time with Part 8. Take care and peace.